This video will show you how to use wetransfer.com for sending large files across the internet. So first of all, we go to the wetransfer website, and when you first arrive at this site, if you've not used it before, you'll get a screen a bit like this saying all about it, and you agree to the system. It now encourages you to buy the expensive version, but we're going to continue with the free version here by clicking here. And this is the screen that you'll most often see when you come to WeTransfer on a subsequent occasion, because it will recognize you and probably remember the email address you used. So let's now decide what files we want to send. So we'll send some journal files here, maybe three files. We put them in and it shows the three files that we're going to send. It tells us how much of the 2 gigabytes we still got remaining, quite a lot. Decide where we want to send the email to. In this occasion, I will send it to myself, so you can see that. And you put in your mail you're sending from here. And you can add a little message. And all you now need to do is to hit transfer. And off we go. And it'll give you progress of uploading the files to the cloud, and once it's done that, it will send an email to the recipient saying you've got some WeTransfer files, and click on a link to download them, and we'll see that in a minute. But we'll just follow this through, and you'll notice that the background screen keeps changing. They do like all these arty photographs and images. There we go, we're almost there, 100%. So it now says that the download email has been sent, and the recipient has got 7 days to download the file, and then it asks us if we want to send another file. So that's all you need to do to send files via wetransfer.com. Now we can have a look at the sequence of emails that both you and the recipient get, so that you understand how the whole system works. Now we can see the sequence of emails that you get after sending a file on wetransfer.com. So first of all, you'll get as the sender an email from WeTransfer here to say your files were successfully sent to that recipient, and it repeats all the information here: the recipient, number of files, who he was, what the files were, and the message you sent. There's also a download link, so you can just check the same download that the recipient's going to get. Now the recipient of the message gets an email like this, again from WeTransfer. It tells you that this person sent you some files and gives you a download button or a direct download link if you prefer. Tells you what the three files are that you're expecting to get. So we click on the Get Your Files, and it takes us to the WeTransfer site, and it tells us here that the files are ready to download. Here are the three files, and we click download, and we get it in the form of a zip file that zip the three files together. So we click on OK, and it will download to wherever your normal download location is. And in my case, we can have a look at that. We open up the download location, unzip it, and there are the three files that we've received. There we go. So once the recipient has downloaded the files, you will get another email to say that the recipient did download your files. And again, it repeats all the information, so you can get confirmation that your files were successfully transferred to the recipient. So that's all there is to using WeTransfer.com, and I hope you'll find that useful and avoid you having to send big sticks in the post in the future. Okay, thank you.